Good morning, friends. Firstly, I'd like to thank Reverend Gordon for inviting me to share the Word of God with you through this devotion. It is an honor and privilege to do so. I greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, let us come before our Father in prayer. Almighty and Heavenly Father, we, your children, come before you this morning on bent knee and with contrite hearts. Abba, we praise, worship, and adore you for all the facets of our lives. Thank you for the rain that fell, causing the Vol Dam and so many others to overflow. But we also thank you for the sunshine that has come, allowing us to enjoy its warmth once more, to stand in bewilderment as we see the rising and the setting of the sun, and as you paint the sky spectacularly with the array of your colors. You are the creator of heaven and earth, and nothing happens without your foreknowledge, as you are omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscient. And for this we worship you. Father, we fall short of your grace every day, and therefore we now humbly ask that you will forgive us our sins and wash us clean as snow, removing our sins as far as the east is from the west, never to be remembered by you. Thank you for washing us clean as snow and forgiving us our transgressions. This we pray in the wonderful name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Reverend Gordon asked me last week if I'd like to share the Word of God with you in devotion, which I gladly accepted. As I started thinking about it and meditating upon it, asking the Lord what to share with you this morning, I started thinking about our present circumstances in Southern Africa. And I realized that things are really tough. Friends, people have lost their employment, in some cases both the husband and wife, as so many businesses have closed their doors or have had to let people go due to the financial implications that this pandemic has caused. People are on edge. They are depressed. Anxiety, stress, worry, anger, and so many other emotions are unchecked and running wild within us. Many families have lost a relative, and in some cases, more than one in a couple of days of each other. Families have been torn apart by death, arguments, fights, and even divorces. As a child of the living God, I become very emotional when I ponder upon these things. They cause so much pain as I feel their pain. As children of Abba, what has carried us through? How have we and how are we going to make it? There are so many promises that encourage us to persevere, not to worry, etc. Today I have chosen a few scriptures that I'd like to share with you that have a golden thread running through them. I have found much encouragement in these verses, as it is one of the promises that I hold to and close to my heart. In Deuteronomy chapter 31 verse 6 we read, "Be strong and courageous. Don't be terrified or afraid of them. For it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you." In Deuteronomy 31 verse 8 we read, "The Lord is the one who will go before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not be afraid or discouraged." In Joshua 1 verses 5 and 6a we read, "No one will be able to stand against you as long as you live. I will be with you, just as I was with Moses. I will not leave you or forsake you. Be strong and courageous." And then in Hebrews 13:5 we read, "Your life should be free from the love of money. Be satisfied with what you have. For he himself has said, I will never leave you or forsake you." May God bless to us this reading from his holy word. Amen. Friends, when things get tough, or when I get downhearted, I think and meditate upon this promise, our Abba, our Father God, Emmanuel, will never leave us or forsake us, no matter what. In a book that I'm currently reading called Jesus Today by Albert Nolan, he writes the following: "The mystery that is God gave birth to me. The mystery must then be more concerned about me than I am about myself. If the mystery is closer to me than I am to myself, and if we are in some profound sense one, then I have nothing to fear. I will be cared for at all times and in all circumstances, Nothing can really harm me, and whatever happens will be for the best. I am loved beyond measure, because I am one with the whole mystery of life. In the first three verses, we are told that we must be strong and courageous, that we must not be terrified, afraid, or discouraged. And the reason why we must not be terrified, afraid, or discouraged, but must be strong and courageous, is our Father is always with us. He will never leave us, not even for a millisecond. Let me repeat that. Our Father is always with us, and He will never leave us. The second reason is that our Father will never forsake us. This means our Father will never abandon, reject, or quit on us. In Hebrews, God tells us not to love money, but to be happy with what we have. And again, He tells us that we will never leave us or forsake us. Although the book of Deuteronomy, Joshua, written BC, before Christ, and Hebrews AC, after Christ, it is as if these scriptures were written for us right now, so that we can take encouragement from them. It is as if the authors of these books knew exactly what we were facing today, and God does. With the world in the shape it is, people are terrified, afraid, and very discouraged. But we are told not to be. We are told to be strong and courageous. We are told to be content with what we have, because our God is always with us. He will never forsake us, no matter what. Friends, take courage from this promise. Hold tight onto it. Wigglesworth said, God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. I would like to leave you with the following scripture, which encapsulates everything I have just shared with you. Isaiah 41:10. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will hold on to you with my righteous right hand. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for revealing your word to us this morning. Scripture that was written hundreds of years ago is very appropriate for us today. You know exactly what each of us is going through, as you know us better than we know ourselves. Thank you for encouraging us through your living word, Father God. Please remove all anxiety and fear from us, and replace it with strength and courageousness, that we may face the future knowing that you are with us, closer than we know, and that you will never forsake us, no matter what. This we pray in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining me this morning in time spent in the Word of God. May the grace, love, protection, and guidance of our Father be with you wherever you go. Until next time, Shalom.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Grace that taught my heart to hear, and grace my faith raised. How precious thing that grace appeared, the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, set.
shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbid to shine, but God who called me here below will be forever mine. Will be forever mine. You are forever mine. You are, you are, you are forever mine. Come on, sing that. You are forever. One more time. You are forever mine. My chains are gone.
I will set free.
Hey.
My God, my Savior, has
been
me.
And I come from
amazing love, amazing grace, amazing love, amazing.